So how do a lot of our receptors work? They're these G protein things, and realize even at rest, your brain likes some serotonergic stuff going on. So notice the blue receptor, the upper triangle is empty, there's nothing bound to it, but it's doing something, right? That G protein sends a second messenger, you change what other proteins are doing and channels are doing, you turn some DNA on or off to make newer different proteins, right? You turn some enzymes on or off. Your brain is always keeping some of your serotonergic activity right where it wants it. It's called constitutive activity. It's always doing something. Your brain is not lazy. We can turn it up. We can turn it to 11, right? Any of you have an amplifier that goes to 11? If you do, that's how you get the 5 kilohertz pitch in your ear when you grow old, right? Too much noise, too much sound. But we can turn it up. Agonism. So if you ever talk about an agonistic drug, for example, it's in this case, it's doing fourfold more stuff. More proteins being created, more channels being opened, more enzymes being started and built, right? So we can agonize a system to make it do more. We can also block it. Notice we put a roadblock on top of this yellow receptor, and notice the activity came back down to low but normal. Constituent activity, right? Constitutive activity. So what happens is you can dial things up or down. That's the way this system works. So we have a spectrum, right? We have researchers, they build us medications. We memorize that the medications can go to a certain serotonin receptor. And does it turn it way up? Does it turn it a little up? Does it turn it down or back to normal? So we can pick and choose how much we want to dial in, right? We don't have many inverse agonists, right? If you're taking a board exam, an inverse agonist does lower activity to zero. We don't have many of those in psychiatry.